Hey, how's it going?
Yeah, things still aren't going well for the 7900 XTX in the VR realm. But while messing around with my AMD GPUs this past week, I was pleasantly surprised by what I discovered about AMD's Radeon 6000 GPUs. The easiest way to explain all this is to just show you, but we need to start with a little bit of background first. A couple months ago, I ran some VR benchmarks on the 7900 XTX. If you haven't seen that video and would like to check it out, it's right up here for you. Anyway, one of my complaints in that video had to do with the fact that the Oculus software was using H.264 to encode the video stream being sent to my Quest 2. So the visuals looked a little blurry compared to how they look using an Nvidia GPU because AMD's H.264 encoder just isn't that great. If I switch the encoder to use H.265 though, the graphics look fantastic with the 7900 XTX. However, the only way I knew to do that at the time was through Virtual Desktop, which if you're not familiar with it, is a $20 app that allows you to connect your Quest 2 to your PC wirelessly, similar to AirLink. Fast forward to a few weeks ago, and I learned that Nvidia GPUs actually default to H.265 encoding when using AirLink. But AMD GPUs, even though they support H.265, the Oculus software was continuing to default them to H.264. As there always is, some very ingenuitive people found you can force AirLink to use H.265 with an AMD GPU by changing a registry entry on your PC. I'm not sure who to give credit to for this because the person that originally posted this info to Reddit deleted their original post. But anyway, they said you can copy and paste this command into your command prompt and it will force AirLink to use H.265. So naturally, I wanted to give it a try. If you would also like to give it a try, I've placed a link to the post in the video description. But before you run off and do that, there's some more stuff you're gonna wanna know. So I opened up my command prompt, copied and pasted this line into it, and pressed enter. It told me the operation completed successfully, so I put on my headset and fired up AirLink. Now, I did all the original benchmarking for my 7900 XTX VR review video using a link cable to get the best possible performance. So I didn't mess with AirLink all that much while making that video. This time around though, as soon as AirLink launched, I noticed that not only did my visuals not look as good as I was expecting them to, but on the right side of my field of view, it looked like things were being squeezed in like this. I tried capturing footage directly to the headset in hopes of being able to show you guys what this looks like, but for whatever reason, it doesn't capture. I know I'm not the only one to experience this though, because searching online for a fix, I came across a number of people experiencing the same problem with the 7900 XTX and the Quest 2. It seems this is a problem Oculus, or Meta, is aware of, but it's not exactly high on their priority list of bugs to fix right now. Anyway, if you're experiencing it, you know what it looks like. This then sent me down a completely different rabbit hole, trying to find a fix for it, but I'll come back to that because I want to finish this encoding stuff first. Since AirLink was giving me this weird right side peripheral squeezing effect, I decided to switch to using a link cable and see if this forcing H.265 thing actually works. I fired up Quest Link, and this is what I got. Not exactly what I was expecting. To see if it was a problem that only existed in the Rift interface, I launched a game, but as you can clearly see, this tearing and stuttering did not go away. If I held really still, it wasn't as bad, but as soon as I moved my head or anything, it was a completely unplayable mess. I tried restarting the Oculus app and even restarting my PC, but the only thing that fixed it was to copy and paste this other command from that same Reddit post, which sets the encoder option back to automatic and defaults us back to H.264. It's now been 5 months since the 7900 XTX launched, and to this day, if you look at the notes on AMD's drivers, they acknowledge the VR performance of their 7000 series GPUs still needs some work. The fact that Virtual Desktop works well using H.265 encoding, though, has me thinking that it's not all AMD's fault here. Oculus needs to get their crap together, too. With things once again not going great for the 7900 XTX, I wondered, what about other AMD GPUs? Do they still default to H.264? I just so happen to have three different Radeon 6000 series GPUs on hand, so I figured I would give them a try. I first popped in the 6700 XT and fired up AirLink, and lo and behold, it defaulted to H.265.
Yeah!
I didn't even have to force it. For fully scientific reasons, and not just to play games and have fun, I tested it out with a few different games, and they all ran smooth and looked super sharp and crisp. I then tried the 6650 XT and the 6950 XT, and got the same result. AirLink now defaults to H.265 encoding for AMD 6000 series GPUs, as it should. Now, whether this is due to an Oculus update within the past few months or has something to do with me forcing H.265 and then setting it back to default, I'm not entirely sure. But what I do know is that those GPUs now deliver just as good looking visuals as my Nvidia GPUs. As for Radeon 5000 GPUs, I don't have any of those to test with, so I don't know if this extends to them as well, but if you have one and use AirLink with it, let me know in the comments which encoder it defaults to. I'd love to know. You can find out which codec AirLink is using through the Oculus Debug Tool. If you've never used it before, to load up the Oculus Debug Tool, you first want to click on the folder icon on your Windows taskbar. Go to your C drive, then to Program Files, Oculus, Support, Oculus Diagnostics, and then double-click on Oculus Debug Tool. Toward the bottom of the window, you'll see Visible HUD. Click on where it says None, and from the drop-down, select Performance. Now click on this little plus sign next to where it says Performance HUD here, and where it says Performance Summary, we want to open that drop-down and select Oculus Link. Now when you launch AirLink, you'll see the HUD like I'm showing here, and next to where it says encoding, it will tell you if you're using H.264 or H.265. Circling back to the 7900 XTX and the right side squeezed field of view issue, on the Oculus forums, I found a post from this guy. I'm not even going to try pronouncing that. Anyway, he found a way to eliminate the squeezing effect. What you do is first open Task Manager. You then scroll down until you find the Oculus processes. You then want to end each of these tasks. Once they're all closed, you want to click on the Windows Explorer folder icon on your taskbar. Go to your C drive, then to Users, then to your profile name, then App Data, and finally Roaming. If you don't see the App Data folder, you'll need to click on View at the top of the window and then tick this box for Hidden Items. You should then see App Data and inside of it, open the Roaming folder. You now want to select your Oculus folder here and delete it. Don't worry, there aren't any saved game files or anything here, so we're not deleting anything of great importance. And when we start up the Oculus app again, this entire folder will be regenerated. With that done, we can start up the Oculus app again, and you'll be prompted to log into your Oculus account. You'll then need to go through the whole process of logging into your account and pairing your headset with your PC again, but once you get that all finished, you can launch AirLink, and at this point, the squeezing on the right side should be gone. The bad news about this is this fix is only temporary. According to the guy who made the forum post, and I have confirmed this, it only works for a total of 2 restarts of the Oculus app. He did find a way though where you don't have to log into your account and pair your headset over and over again. So here's what you're going to need to do next if you're wanting to use your 7900 XTX with AirLink and want to get rid of that weird right side squeezing thing. We now need to go back to our PC, to that Oculus folder we deleted earlier. So C, Users, Your Name, App Data, Roaming, and then Oculus. From here, we now need to go into the Sessions folder, and then this one that's just a long string of numbers. And we want to copy these 2 files here, data.sqlite and data.sqlite-wal. You'll then want to create a new folder here. I'm just going to call mine temp and then paste these files into this folder. Our forum guy that discovered this calls these our magic files. Sadly, until Oculus fixes this squeezing bug, you're going to need to copy these files into the long string of numbers folder every time before starting up the Oculus app to play PC VR. Yes, I know it's a pain to have to do this every time you want to play something, but it's much better than deleting the whole Oculus folder and having to log into your account and pair your headset over and over again. Also, I should mention, when pasting your magic files in, you'll want to delete all of the bad data.sqlite files before pasting the magic ones in. You may have a third data.sqlite-shm file in addition to the other two, and you'll want to make sure to delete that one also. In my experience trying this, it did eliminate the squeezing problem, but it also defaults the 7900XTX to H.264 encoding. I tried forcing H.265 and then doing all of this, but with H.265 encoding enabled, this whole deleting the Oculus folder fix did not work. It only worked if I allowed it to default to H.264. Going into this, I had hoped enough time had gone by since my review of the 7900XTX that things would be working better. Sadly, as of the making of this video, the 7900XTX is still kneecapped when it comes to playing VR with a Quest 2. And who knows when AMD and Oculus will finally get this stuff patched up and working properly. Just my luck though, now that I've spent all this time making this video, it'll all be fixed in the next update, and this video will be instantly obsolete. Such is life, I guess. The 6000 series defaulting to H.265 now is really exciting though. Yeah, they aren't the latest and greatest GPUs on the market, but they do all perform really well, and when compared to the new stuff, are a much better value when it comes to price to performance, and you can see how their performance stacks up against one another in this playlist here. Subscribe!